in my quest back in 2011, I've been in real estate for 21 years. And back in 2011, I kind of looked at the 66 houses that were bought that year. And I said, what was it about these houses that was similar? Or what is a generic or stereotypical story that I could say about these houses that we bought? And we kind of came up with this, what I still use today, that the best leads come from somebody that usually just moved into senior living, the adult children of seniors. They, you know, mom's been living on her own for 8 years since dad passed away. She's been doing the best she could with the house. She's been on a fixed income. Something just happened to mom again, right? You don't move a healthy mom into senior living. Something like a fall or a surgery or something happens to mom where she can't take care of herself anymore. Now the adult children are trying to figure out, where is mom going to get the best care? And then how the heck do we pay for it? And what do we do with all the stuff? And so I help with the house and the stuff. And so that's kind of been my, how I fell into what I call these pre-probate leads or these senior living leads. People, when they hear senior living, they think I buy senior living communities. That's not what I do. I help the adult children of seniors move mom into the senior living communities.
Very cool, and appreciate the clarification there. I think one thing you do is that's pretty much a mandatory as an entrepreneur, no matter what business you're in. Most of you listening to this are going to be in real estate, obviously, but kind of going back and reviewing, like Philip was talking about, just like what was like the successful caricature of how you're getting leads. And you can do that in a lot of different aspects of your business. But obviously that's led to Philip finding it. And I can't remember if we were talking last week or you said another podcast, but the pre-probate, we'll call it, has been your best lead source since 2011, you said?
Since 2011. Yeah, I mean,
since 2011.
Clearly the best. It's been so good, Carlos, that I've been keeping it a secret that long. I didn't want anybody else to do this in St. Louis, you know? So I've been keeping this one a secret for myself. I knew I had something good there. And so, you know, times change and now I'm trying to grow this thing nationwide. So now it's like, I got to go out and tell people my secret and show them exactly what I've done. You know, that's the big thing too. You want to talk about senior living. How we talk as real estate investors is not even close to how you talk in the senior living community. That world, it's a very insulated world. It's a very private world. You truly have to care about people. If you don't care about people, it's not something you should mess around with. The people in senior living will see right through the bad actors in the industry.
Mm-hmm. Love that, man. Well, let's touch on a little bit of all of that. I guess first, let's talk about why that has been the best quality of lead source for you, a shade under a decade. What makes it such a great lead? And then let's talk about actually finding them and then maybe how we can, you know, how someone potentially could partner up with you or work with you on these pre-probate leads nationwide. Because I know you're trying to get your voice out there and would be powerful to connect you with folks that are listening to this.
Yeah, your first question, I think, was
why is it the best quality of lead for you since 2011?
When I look for a lead or you look for a lead, when I say the royal we of us as investors, what I mean is we're looking for people that have motivation and equity. If a person doesn't have motivation or equity, that's not really a real estate lead in my mind. Very rarely do we buy houses from people our age. I know, Carlos, you're younger than me, but I'm, you know what I mean? Like, under 60-ish, let's say. You know, I'm 42, you're much younger than me. And so we don't normally buy houses from people our age. On the rare occasion we do, but most of the time, we're as investors, we're trying to look for houses where we can add value. And those houses are normally houses that somebody's lived in for a long time that they didn't do the updates on, right? So you've got this perfect storm of, it's not about the money because it will come down to the money. But in that moment, when you're moving mom into senior living and you find out that her cost of living just went up exponentially, because you're not going to take her to the dumpy place in town. You're going to take her to the nice senior living community, right? There's this guilt involved with taking mom to senior living. So now you got to figure out a way to pay for it. And mom has a pension, but not a lot of savings. So always it comes down to the house that she bought in 1973 that's got shag carpet from 1973. You know, like these houses that are the ones that we're looking for, the ones that we can add value to. Mm-hmm. The family in that moment, they're trying to get mom the best care. And so they have to come in from, you know, the average, I think they said the average is adult child lives 400 miles away from mom. Well, if you live 400 miles away from mom, are you going to do a good rehab of that house? You know?
Yeah, definitely not.
you know, you go meet with a real estate agent and they say, step one, clean out the house. That right there is easily a 60-day project. The houses I looked at three houses this morning. They're all full of stuff. You know, life happens. It's like, what do you do with the stuff? So even the stuff could be a non-starter. People are like, I'm never going to get this house retail ready because there's so much work to do on the front end and I don't even live in this town, right? So I come in as this guy who's gonna make a reasonable offer. I wanna do what I say, help them with the stuff, help. Almost be like a quarterback to unlock this puzzle that they're dealing with as a family. And Carlos, you see the weight get lifted off the family's shoulders. When you do this right, you can really help people and find really good houses to buy. I mean, I take a lot of pride in what I do. And I feel like even if I get a lead from senior living, even if I can't help that person, like buy it, like if they're going to say no to my offer, that's fine. But I'm going to give them so much value because so often these adult children tell me I was not prepared for any of this. There's no manual or book you can take on how to help mom through the senior living process, you know? And so it's one of those things where, like right now, my mission, if I could just say exactly what my mission is to find the right investors nationwide to work with on these leads, because I truly care about the people side of it. If you don't care about the people side, it's going to be a hard road.